Hi, I'm Annie. I taught a flowers kind of mixed level class. We started out stretching because flowers can be really harsh on your shoulders, so if you're going to do it, make sure you warm up. And then I just sort of introduced the idea that flowers are basically what you can already do with koi, just the different timing, direction patterns. But you're doing it with your arms instead. So there's same direction, same time. There's opposite direction, same time. There's opposite direction, split time. And those are all wall plane and inside plane. There's split time, same direction, or the flowers, or the butterflies rather. And when you do them, try not to torque your shoulders. If you're doing, for example, this flower, turn with it. You can take steps, and then you can turn in a full circle, or you can take steps and go just not turn. And then introducing koi into the mix and doing the extension, and then stopping and doing one petal, and then doing that one petal in a different place, and then doing multiple petals. Pay attention to these points, these kind of quadrant points, if it helps to stop and snap your fingers and make sure it's lined up. Those are crucial points for most flowers and for transitions later. And then introduce inspin and antispin. So inspin, when your koi and your arm are rotating in the same direction. Antispin, when they're going in opposite directions. I introduce that by spinning, so it's going up in front of you on its side, and then just going to do it with blocks. And the same on the bottom. And then getting into a circle with that. And then different uses that flowers can have, such as if you're doing crossers, and you want to switch which arm's on top. You could do anti-spin with one direction, not so well with the other direction. Let's see. These sorts of flowers for transitioning for buzz saws. Anything else? I think that's kind of it.